You can upload your overlays, you can import alert boxes, you can do everything in this browser to create your entire stream, and then it gives you one link for a single browser source. I've created entire scenes in stream elements that were like 20 layers, and it consolidates them down to one layer, which really lightens the load on your PC. Those are the first two things I would do because you're not lowering the quality of your stream at all. So now you've eliminated 10 unnecessary sources. What is the last little bit you can do to save yourself some CPU power? Well, if you go to your output settings, you will see something called encoder preset. It'll even say in there, higher equals less CPU, and it'll range from ultra fast down to slower. Essentially what this means is how much time the CPU spends on each frame. It's like, have you seen those images of a cartoonist spending a minute on a cartoon frame and then 10 seconds on a cartoon frame? You can see the quality of difference between them. The faster is going to look less, but it's easier on the computer because it doesn't have to spend as much time on all the details. So the faster you set your encoder preset, the easier it's gonna be on your CPU, but you will see some of that weird pixelation going on your screen when you have a lot of movement at a time. I found that if you set it any slower than faster, there's not really much of a difference. I tried setting it on slowest. It clocked my CPU percentage up to 80%, and I saw no difference between that and faster. I mean, maybe like this much, but that's what we call diminishing returns. It's not worth it. I usually run it faster, and I brought it down to fastest, and it was a very minor change, but it dropped my CPU percentage almost in half. In fact, to test this whole thing before filming this, I dropped my resolution down to 720p, kept it at 60 frames per second, even kept the bit rate the same, and dropped the CPU preset down to very fast from faster, and my CPU usage went from about 32% down to 12%. That's almost down to a third of what the original processing power was. I actually left it at that. I'm sick of my CPU going up to almost 40% at crazy times. I want it to stay down to 12. On top of everything else, if your computer is still struggling, there's one other thing you can do. The very last setting I would recommend you toy with is the encoder. I know a lot of you guys getting your gaming PCs really emphasize the GPU, and you get a 1080, but you've only got an i5 in your computer. If you change your encoder to hardware, what it's actually doing is it's taking a load off your CPU, and instead of encoding your stream with your CPU, you're gonna be encoding it with your GPU. This might not work for a single PC stream because that GPU is running on max for most of your games, especially if you're running poorly optimized games like PUBG. But if you're running a well-optimized game like Fortnite, you might have some headroom to spare. I have a GTX 1070 in my streaming PC,